Welcome to the Berlin Film Festival. We're very excited to be here, and now for the next couple of days, we're going to be covering the festival as much as we can. And now I'm standing on the red carpet, and behind me we have the Berlin Film Palace. And of course, this is the place where all the premiere is going to take place. So we're going to try to take as much as interviews we can with both the directors and the actors. So now let's see what Berlin has to offer. Right behind me, we have the red carpet, and we're standing here at the Berlin Film Festival. And for tonight, the main screening is Elbow, and it's going to have its showing here tonight. And very soon, the actors and the people that's been making the movie is going to come in here at the red carpet. And we're just waiting for them, and we're going to hopefully take some interviews. So then we have the main actors here in the background. Blanca, short interview, Blanca, short interview. Blanca, welcome to Berlin Film Festival.
I'm really happy. I haven't seen the film yet, so this is my first time.
How does it feel now? It's a premiere tonight and you're here in Berlin. Feels good?
I feel really good and I feel nervous too, so it's a very, very special night.
Yeah. Yeah. Tell us shortly about your character in the movie.
Well, you have to see, but my character is Elena, and it's a good girl who suddenly appears in that bar and she tries to survive.
What have been the best part with making this movie?
Meet all the rest of the actors, work again with Alex, and live this amazing experience. Yes.
Thank you so much, and have a great night.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you. We just got a few words with Blanca, that has one of the main acting roles in the movie Elbow, that has its screening now here in Berlin tonight. Now we're at the Berlin Film Palace, and tonight and very soon the movie Joachim has its premiere here, and we're very excited. And very soon the actors and the director and the people that have made the movie are coming here very soon at the red carpet. So hopefully we're gonna get some interviews with them. Right behind me, the main actress is arriving. We see Isabel, Julio, and Walkett. So we're going to try to catch them now. Yes, short here. Marcelo, nice to have you here.
Well, thank you very much.
Welcome to the Berlin Film Festival. Does it feel good now?
I feel very happy. I think it's a great festival. And the people that come to the festival, they really love the films. They really want to know more about the countries, the social and political issues of the country throughout the cinematography. They are very curious people, and I'm very happy to be here.
Tell us shortly about the movie tonight.
The movie is about the fractures of the process of colonization of Brazil, the social fractures that happened during Portugal colonized Brazil.
Okay, then I wish you a good night.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Okay, Isabel, come in here. We can work together here. We can work together.
Okay.
Okay, now we're standing here with Isabel and Julio that have made the movie Joachim, and you're the main actors. Welcome to Berlin.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Can you tell us shortly about the movie?
It's a power movie and politic and very strong from Brazil and from around the world.
And you are playing against Julio?
Yes. We are a couple in the film.
wished that the peoples received the message. We try to reflect about our situation now in Brazil, yeah. Between this movie.
Yeah. Okay, thank you. And Isabel, thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Now we've just seen the movie Joaquim, and now we're standing here at the press conference, and very soon the actors and the director is going to come in here, and hopefully we are going to ask some questions as well to them.
My name is Marcus, I work for Swedish television. I want to ask a question for Marcelo Gomez. First question is, what was the challenging with making these movies? And the second question is, was it difficult to find the right costumes for the actors?
The challenge, I mean, the biggest one. Well, we had many, many challenges. One of them is to make a historical movie with such a budget we had. A low budget. And that was a miracle, almost. And our producer, João Júnior, has done lots of miracles. This is the fifth miracle he does. It's the fifth film we make together. It was really difficult because we wanted not beautiful landscape, but dramaturgic landscape. Oh, I'm speaking English, sorry.
Yes, now we're standing here at the Berlin Film Festival at the red carpet, and we're waiting for Milena Canero, the big designer. So hopefully she's going to come soon and we're going to get an interview with her. Milena has been designing clothes for many big movies, and she's also going to get a prize here tonight at the film festival. Milena! Filmar du? Milena, welcome to the Berlin Film Festival.
Thank you.
How does it feel to be here?
Great.
Great. And you've been designing clothes and dresses for many big movies, and now you're going to get a prize tonight. What does this prize mean to you?
It means that for me and for my profession, for my colleagues, and for my collaborators, it's a great award, not just for me, but for everybody else who works in the costumes.
Yeah. And which movies have you designed the costumes for?
Well,
so many.
There's so many.
I don't know. Out of Africa, yeah. Barry Lyndon, Dick Tracy, yeah. The Shining tonight.
Right behind me we have the red carpet here at the Berlin Filmpalast, and tonight the movie Anna Mon Amour has its premiere, and very soon the actors and the director is going to come, and hopefully we're going to get some interviews. I'm sitting here with Jana. Welcome to Berlin Film Festival.
Thank you, I'm really excited, thank you so much.
Can you tell us shortly about your character in the movie?
Oh my God, it's so complicated, I cannot say it shortly, but it's a really powerful character, and it's in three stages. You can see it young, you can see her young, in her younger days, and then divorced, and with her mental illness that's changing her whole relation with her husband, and but it's a happy ending.
Yeah. And shortly, what have been the best thing with this whole journey with the movie?
The best thing?
Yeah.
Well, this is the best thing. It's the most exciting part,
yeah.
since we finished the shootings.
Yeah. Hey, thank you so much, and have a good night.
Thank you very much.
First of all, welcome to Berlin Film Festival.
Thank you. Glad to be here.
Yeah. Your character, can you quickly describe it?
Yeah, he's a scared little child.
That's what I think about him. He's always trying to impress everybody. He's always obsessed about what everybody thinks about him, what he should do, and he puts a lot of worries on himself, on his shoulders.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Tonight it's a Friday evening and we're now standing at the red carpet just outside the Berlin Filmpalast. And tonight the premiere is Logan, and we are very excited. There's many people around here. And so now we're just only waiting for the actors and the director. So hopefully we're gonna see Hugh Jackman and Patrick Stewart and so on. As you can see, Hugh Jackman just arrived, so many people are excited now, so we're going to try to get an interview with him.
Yeah.
Hugh Jackman, once again.
I'm welcome. Rolling a ball halfway through. Go for it.
Okay. You've been part of many great movies. How does it feel now? We're standing here in Berlin and Logan is premiering very soon.
I'm so proud of the movie. It's the end of a 17-year journey for me, and I was very nervous about it because it had to be right, and I can't wait for audiences to see it. For me, this is the definitive movie about this character.
Now I'm standing here with James McGall, you're the director of the movie, and it's finally premiere. What are your feelings?
Oh, it's just so beautiful to be here in Berlin tonight and finally premiere the film here in Germany.
Can you feel the atmosphere now?
Can I what?
Can you feel the atmosphere?
I can feel it. I not only feel the atmosphere, it's raining down upon me, but no, it's great.
And just shortly, what have been the challenges with producing the movie?
Well, directing this film, my greatest challenge was just trying to get it right. It's all, everyone who worked on the film have been friends and have worked together for years, and we just wanted a way to end the Wolverine saga in a way that is strong and profound and worthy of the character.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome, Logan himself, Hugh Jackman. Great to have you. And please welcome the producer, Simon Kinberg. Welcome to Berlin.
What will you miss the most of your character? And would you like to play Wolverine in a musical? Maybe in the future.
Let me start with the second. No. They may do one, but I won't be in it. Will you direct it? The musical?
No.
First of all, thank you to Dieter, thank you to everyone for having us. I'm not just saying that as lip service, this is a dream for us, because we set out together, Jim and I at the beginning, and then with everyone here, and Emma and Steve who are here, knowing it was the last time I would play the role, we set out to make a movie that was not defined by genre, that wouldn't be defined by a rating, or wouldn't be defined by previous films in the franchise, but just to make a great movie. The fact we were at the Berlin Film Festival is a dream come true for us. And so thank you. And so I've got to be honest, when I saw the movie, I was very nervous, knowing what was at stake for me. And I was so, it exceeded my expectations. But I looked at that character, there were some moments I cried in weird places, like carrying Charles Xavier up the stairs, like places, just moments, and I thought, I loved that character. And I can't say I'll miss him because it's difficult to describe. It's not going anywhere for me. It will always live here. The fans will remind me every single day or second day of my life whether we got it right or wrong. It's part of who I am, and it's a journey I'm so, so grateful for.
Thank you.
I won't miss the chicken breasts, let me tell you that.
Tonight is the prize ceremony here at the Berlin Filmpalast, and it's going to take place very soon. So now we're just waiting for all the actors to arrive here on the red carpet. So we are very excited and looking forward to it. And hopefully we're going to take some interviews here. I'm standing here with Mr. Costley, that's the director of the festival. Welcome.
Thank you.
What do you think about the festival so far? Are you happy?
The festival so far ends in a couple of minutes. And yes, I'm very happy. It was a very special edition this year. With very special films, like they had a lot of humor, and anyways, they showed how the world is, and the people have been in good mood here, and they all stand together because they have the feeling that something has to be changed in the world. A lot of negative things are going on, wars and governments who become crazy. Yeah, I feel good, and I think after the decision of the jury we will hear in a couple of hours, everybody will feel good.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. What do you do? Hello.
This is a mind, but... So now it's the final night of the Berlin Film Festival, this prize ceremony tonight. Are you looking forward to it?
Oh my god, yeah, I'm really excited. I'm looking forward to it, of course, but it's with all kind of emotions. Yeah. So yeah, it's really interesting.
Does it feel good now after your movie had its premiere here in Berlin?
Of course, there's not so much pressure on us, and we try to enjoy the night and be happy because we're here. Yeah.
And if we're just looking back on your movie, what have been the best parts with this whole journey with the movie?
Well, I think that...
From you read the script for the first time, or...?
Yeah, I think the ones we worked on it, we are all really happy that we met, and it's really important because I think we did a great job, so yeah, we are here, so that means someone has the same opinion with us, so yeah. It's okay, yeah.
Thank you so much.
Thank
Have
you
a good
so
night.
Much. Bye.
Bye. Welcome to the Berlin Film Festival.
Thank you, thank you.
So tonight is the final night, the prize ceremony. What are your feelings?
Oh, I'm feeling very relaxed, even though Stellan is not here, which means he didn't get an award. But I think if anybody deserved an award tonight as the best actor is Stellan. It's been wonderful to work with him. We became partners on this project.
Is he coming tonight?
No, he is not coming. He would have come if he had an award. If he is not here, that means no award for Stellan.
Yeah. And are you?
He doesn't need it. No. He is a great character anyhow.
Yeah. If you just quickly looking back to the whole journey before you were starting the movie.
Yeah.
What have been the best part with the whole journey?
I think the very first reading. Like more than a year ago in September 2015, Stellan and Nina Hoss came to Berlin over a weekend, and we were reading the screenplay. And all of a sudden I had the feeling it works. Now all we have to do is find the money and one day to shoot it. But this was the moment of bliss.
Yeah. Thank you so much. Now we recently left the red carpet and now we are inside a press conference. And very soon, all the actors and the people around the movies that have got some prizes for tonight, they're gonna come back here now for the press conference. So in a very few minutes, this place is gonna be full of journalists and all the actors that's been winning the prizes.
This wonderful lady won the Silver Bear for an outstanding artistic contribution. It's for the editing of the film Anna Mon Amour, and this is Dana Brunescu. Congratulations for your Silver Bear. These are the winners of the Silver Bear for the best script. Sebastian Melo and Gonzalo Maza, and the Lord, the fantastic woman, Daniela Vega. Welcome and congratulations. So, So,